to part two of this month's prompt, which is bubbles, bling and confetti. In our last video, which I'll put a link up somewhere, maybe there, might be good, we looked at the background and we created the bubbles. This time round, I want to look at the foreground and the detail that will embellish the rest of the painting or picture. But what I want to do first is just briefly explain what I do as regards art journaling. I don't have a written journal as such. What I tend to do is have an artist's drawing pad kind of thing, a bit like this, and it has experimental ideas in it, and it's a visual reference for me of layout drawings like that. For example, finished drawings, I'll keep notes on how to do various things and what I intend on using. That really is what I use journals for, but I want to be able to do work in different journals or different pieces of artwork and then paste pieces of work into some separate journals later on in the year in a retrospective review of them. But let's get on with doing our foreground work. And what I've decided to do is a dragon, but this is no ordinary dragon. It doesn't breathe fire, it breathes bubbles. It's the bubble dragon. So let's have a look at what we're going to do then. So here are some of the basic bits of equipment that I'm going to be using. We're going to be creating confetti. So I've got this, if you can see it. It's paper that has a metallic finish on it. There's various different colours. We have some very thin double-sided sticky tape, some glue to glue all this paper down, and we'll also be using some of this metallic, I believe they call it mirror board, but we'll be using these as a main basic for the embellishment of the rest of the picture. So to start with, what I had to do is come up with some sort of design for the dragon that I'm going to be putting in, and I was very influenced by the old Chinese dragons. In essence, the head is what I'm after. I will do that off camera because it is a very complicated piece of work. So what I've done is, using what you would call an X-Acto knife or a crafting knife, I've cut out I've drawn onto a piece of the mirror board and glued it to that. So that is going to be the main feature of the actual artwork, and we'll work on the rest of the body as it snakes around the image. What I'm going to do is trace out these hands or arms or whatever you want to call them, and we'll produce those. So I can show you the process I went through to create the head. A pencil, and pressing down reasonably hard. I'm going to trace around it.
I've put the gold mirror board underneath the paper. Pressing onto it will make an impression into it.
And that, hopefully, will have transferred onto the gold board. Right, I'm going to use this knife now, and I'm going to go around the edges of the arms that we're doing.
Very carefully with a knife, you can cut round this. You can use scissors if you feel more comfortable with it.
So now we have the two arms. I'll now get the silver. What I'm going to do now is draw a silver outline round it, very basically, just to mount it onto. Right, I'll just show you that, and then I'll complete the work off camera.
Just an outline, about an eighth of an inch or a couple of millimetres, just so it can mount on the top.
So we have the outline, and then we're going to cut that out.
Again, we're carefully, bit by bit, cutting round the silver section that we drew out earlier. And just be careful with the knife, because they are very sharp.
That's ready to pull out. We'll just tease it out. And that basically would be how you do it. Obviously, you've got to glue it all together. So now we're at the stage where started to lay down the dragon and the main sections, the head, the arms, and this flourish area. What I'm going to do now is plot out exactly where the rest of the body is going to go. I'm going to basically draw out now a rough idea of where I want it to go.
I'm using a colour pencil so you can see this. But I'm going to go in and out of the page and curl it back round to the end.
So that's that plotted out. And what I'm going to do is cut pieces of paper out, which will be the confetti, and start adding it to this line that I've created. My idea for the scales for the body came from this particular material. See how it's like, it's pieces of paper layered on top of one another, and that's what I'm going to do. But what I'm going to do is a circular bubble on top of each other like that. So I've got this paper, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut some circles out, lots of them, and as you'll see, the different colours. I hope I can just cut them all as a group so it don't take as much messing about, but we'll see about that. Let's see if I can draw a circle around this. Right, we're going to cut these out. So I'm happy with this kind of setup and arrangement. What I'll be doing with the circles is exactly what you can see here. A random laying out of the different coloured circles in the shape where I've marked out. As you can see, I've glued these sections down, and this is all glued down now, and the arms. What I've done here is added some double-sided sticky tape. I'll peel it off and expose the sticky part, and then I'm going to add hot foil tape. So you can also get it in this gold roll thing.
Give it a good firm rub and it should stay on there okay.
Yeah, it's kind of come through, isn't it? I don't know if you can see it properly on there, so we'll keep on with this kind of thing. So basically that's everything in the process of doing the dragon done. So what I now need to continue to do is the rest of the area like that. So that is all the bubbles that make up the body done up to that point. What I will do with the rest of these is add the embellishments that are needed and then do this tail section. Right, we're going to do the finishing edges round these sections now. So we've got the gold line all the way around. We just need to do this silver lining around the outer edge and bring it to there, and then I'll probably finish with some sort of decorative bit there. As you can see, that's done now, and we've got all the other areas as well done, and like I said, I'm probably going to do some sort of embellishment there. So that's this section of it done. We'll finish that bit off and then we'll start wrapping up really, because all I want to do really is try and key in the bubbles into the dragon. So this is the finished dragon. I've done all the way around the dragon itself, right to this tail section here that I've created some embellishments for. What I've also done is done some outlining of the scaled areas that are the circle bubbles all the way around it, and I've also added the hot foil to the outer edge. So that's basically it done for the time being. What I will do in the next part of the process is tie it all together so we've not just got a background and a foreground. Now, I could do that in a traditional way onto this piece of paper, but I am going to show you how to do that digitally. So we'll do some finishing work in a digital format, and we'll also tidy the artwork up and do the finishing like that.
As a recap, we created bubbles. We did several experiments on various different papers with different techniques, including brusho and Indian ink, and we eventually came to our background that you can see here. And once we'd done that, we started preparing the dragon's head, which is the bling side of things. For the confetti, we added circles for the body. So that's been my artwork. Thanks for coming and having a look.